同学们好，今天我来讲一下第一课的课文和语法，我会讲得快一点，因为我在录音。第一课开学，大学一年级的新生，大学一年级，first year in college，新生，new student，what versus 老生，like 他是新生，他们是老生。快开学了。Oh, by the way, these are the sentences from the textbook. 快开学了。School's going to start. So, 开学。That means almost something. Something's gonna happen soon. For example, 快下雨了。It's going to rain. 快到了。Are we there yet? 我们到了吗？快到了。It's about to get there. Le here means the changes of the status. 我们学习了 le 的用法。le 的用法。你的新学期计划 or 打算 the new term. What kind of plan do you have? Alright. 他家离学校很远，很远，得坐飞机去学校。小张天明家离学校很远，得坐飞机去学校。离 that's away, 远 or 近 far or close. 我家离学校很远，我得开车去学校。But some professor 离学校很近，他走路去学校 walk. So this is day third tone. That means have to. Also can be pronounced as 得 That means again. For example, 得感冒。To, I couldn't say gain, to have a cold, a sickness. 得了感冒，得了感冒。And also, neutral tone would be 的 describe the verb. Like, 我说的很快，他讲的很好，你吃的很多，那得。坐飞机坐了两个小时。So, this is another le structure with time.Measurement verb with time measurement. Basically, the first verb can be omitted since you mentioned it here. So object plus verb plus le plus time to see the duration of the time. For example, 你学汉语学了多长时间 or 你汉语学了多长时间 How long have you learned Chinese? Have been learning Chinese? 我学汉语学了三年 So follow the structure. 我汉语学了三年。Or you can say 我吃饭吃了半个小时 verb 了 plus time. We eaten for 3 hours. Alright. So 下飞机以后马上叫了一辆出租车。下飞机 off the plane 以后 after 以前 before. So you had to put something 以后 something 以前 after of the plane. 马上马 horse 上 on it.Literally means immediately. 叫了一辆出租汽车。So, well, that's the action time plus 以前以后, right? For example, 你下课以后做什么? After class, what do you do? 你下课以后做什么? That's 马上。叫了一辆出租车, you use the word to call. Well, that's like in the past, you call taxi. Now you can just use your phone app and Lyft, Uber, right? So, 叫了一辆出租车，or you can use the word 打车，叫车，either is okay。叫车，since we learn 叫车，一辆汽车，that's major word for cars。汽车，of course，出租 literally means renting，出租汽车，出租车 taxi。一辆公共汽车，公共，that means public，汽车，car，bus，bus。But you have to say 一架。飞机帮新生搬东西，叫、so, 帮 somebody do something to help someone with something, right? 帮 help new student 搬 to move 东西 things. Or you can use 帮忙，but 帮忙 is a verb and object structure. You cannot say 我帮忙你，but you can say 帮我一个忙。So, HP 帮新生。老生帮先生搬东西。 是从中国来的，是在美国长大的。So，张天明的爸爸妈妈是从中国来的，可是张天明是在美国长大的。The 是 and the structure, which we learned before, we reviewed again. So that talk about something that happened, then you go into details, talk about the time, the manner, or the place, when that something happened, right? For example, 你是怎么来学校的? So have. How did you come to school? You use 是, then put 怎么来学校, have come school, then put the at the end. First 是 can be omitted, the cannot. Alright? Well, you can answer, 我是坐飞机来学校的。我是坐出租车来学校的，or 我们坐火车来学校的。我们是坐火车从上海到北京的。我正在学中文，Colin introduced 介绍他自己。我正在学中文，so 正在 or 在 plus do something as kind of continuous tense。我们正在上课，我们正在上中文课。We are having Chinese class. Then 张天明解释 explains，我先坐飞机 first took flight，从机场到学校坐出租汽车 from airport to school taking taxi. So 先 something 再 something. Well, 再 is not here, but normally use this structure, right? 从 something 到 something that means from 机场 to 学校，or you can see the time like from 9 to 11 o'clock. You can see 从九点到11点。So 你觉得住在校外好还是住在校内好？觉得 we learn the word that means to think. 想 is similar means to think, but 觉得 means opinion. So 校内校外 外 that's outside。Campus, off campus, 校内 name is inner, in campus, 还是 that means or, right? And we learn those words, 可是 but, 但是 also but, 要是 if, 还是 can only be used in a question. If you want to use or in a statement, you have to use this word, 或者 for example, 你喝茶还是喝咖啡？you can say, 哇，我喝茶或者咖啡，so either way is okay。又方便又安全，又方便又安全。the 又 something 又 structure use adjective。For example, look at this apple 苹果，so you can say 这个苹果又大又红。Big and red, right? So, Chinese train, bullet train, 中国的火车又快又方便，or 又快又便宜，cheap 又快又舒适 means comfortable, 舒适，right? 安全 safe, 比较便宜，比较便宜，我住在校外，比较便宜，so。太便宜了，比较。That means relatively speaking, relatively. Also means to compare. 便宜，very useful word, cheap. 便宜点行吗？Be a little bit cheaper, okay, 行。So that's something you use often in China when you're bargaining. 便宜点行吗？So 除了想省点钱以外。Colin explains why he lived off campus. 他住在校外，除了想省点钱以外，besides want to save some money, right? So 除了 something 以外，that means besides something or except something. We don't tell the difference between two, right? 省点钱 save a little money. 省 to save. 省钱，save money；省电，save electricity；省油，save gas。住在校外，自由。Well, besides saving money，除了省点钱以外，住在校外 校外自由，自由啊。I mean, here's a verb, not just free, as in an adjective, right? A verb, a noun here. So 自由，很自由。That would be an adjective. 啊，不自由，not, not free. All right. But that phrase is not the same free as this one, 免费, that is free of money. So 自由 can only be used to describe the status of free or freedom. So 免费 means free of money. Look at here, 免费, that's the 免费, right? 升级, upgrade way, to be 大杯, big cup. 再说,住在校外也不见得方便。再说, in addition, besides, 住在校外也不见得, not necessarily very convenient, 很方便, right? So that's 再说,不见得, not necessarily. Well, normally, 住在校外很方便。So that is why it's saying 住在校外 not also necessarily 很方便 right? For example, the sentence 贵的不见得比便宜的好 So be compare expensive ones 贵的不见得 not necessarily 比便宜的好 So better than cheap ones So 便宜的不见得比贵的差How to translate that? Cheap ones, not necessarily, 不见得比贵的差。差差 false tone means bad in quality, right? So worse than 贵的 expensive ones. 方便 that means convenient. So, 要是你方便 if you're convenient, 我现在不方便 I'm not convenient today.Alright, well, I have 3 more minutes. 那我以后也搬到校外去。So, 那 or 那么 means then. 我以后,以后 Remember, here means later. Not necessarily after something, right? 以前 you know, that means before. 我是个学生。现在我是老师。So, 以后搬到校外去。来 or 去 that's directional word, right? 你搬到校外校内来 to live on campus or 搬到校外去 off campus. 你刚来在学校住对你有好处。So, 刚来你刚来 you just came, just arrived. 刚 means just. For example, 刚到美国 just arrived in America, 刚回来 just return, right? 刚 is an adverb.Compared to 刚才, the word we learned, I mean, 刚才 is a noun, is a time noun, right? They're different. First of all, this adverb, noun. Second, 刚才 refers to shorter time. Again, 10 minutes, 15 minutes, maybe half hour at most would be 刚才, right? For example, what would you fill in this one? 我, it should be 刚去了中国, been to China, went to China, I just...Went to China, right? 我刚去了中国。You don't say 我刚才去了中国。Well, unless, you know, it took you just half an hour to get there and come back. 对你有好处。对 someone, here means for. 对你有好处。For you has benefit. That's a structure. 对 something 有好处。对 something 没有好处。For example, 跑步。对你有好处。Running, 跑步。I have 1 more minute. Need to finish. 可以适应一下学校的生活。So, 可以 you may 适应一下 to adapt to get used to school's life. For example, 刚来的时候很不适应。Really not used to. 现在适应了。Adapted to. So, 生活 means life. 你生活的怎么样 How did you live? It's a verb, a noun, right?一定请你帮忙。So, 一定,一定 that means must, definitely will, 不见得 not necessarily, not must. 请你帮忙,帮一个忙 help someone, 帮我忙 right? So, to ask you to help, I will definitely ask you for help. 前边没人了,前边没人了。So, 前边 后边、左边、右边、